Every trader wants to have a good trading performance. They want to trade larger positions. They want to have a stable performance. And most importantly, they want to be able to survive longer in the market. Well, this is not an easy pathway. It's a pathway that filled with lots of challenges. However, it is not impossible to achieve. And I believe you want your trading to be sustainable over the long run, isn't it? Hi, and welcome to our excellent YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to share with you the three key elements you need to pay attention to help you move towards a sustainable trading for the medium to long term. Once you manage to solve these three elements, you will see improvements in your trading. If you're new to our YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our informative updates. We have got some great content coming up to help you improve your trading and investing knowledge and skills every week. Thanks for tuning in. So let's get started. The first element, preparing your trading capital. Now this is crucial for long-term success and to ensure that your trading activities don't negatively affect your financial stability. I'm going to share with you several important points on how to prepare your trading capital. If you want to trade, please trade with excess money. Excess money that you can afford to lose. Only use funds that you can afford to lose without significant impact on your financial well-being. This ensures that your trading activities won't put your basic needs at risk. This also means that always avoid trading with scared money. Now, trading with money that you are afraid to lose can lead to emotional decision-making and impulsive actions, which are disadvantageous to successful trading. Before you allocate funds to trading, make sure you have sufficient emergency fund that is set aside for unexpected expenses or emergencies. This ensures that your basic financial needs are covered regardless of your trading outcomes. And lastly, the most importantly, all of us comes to the same point, is that you want to make sure that the money you put for trading has no impact on your current lifestyle. Your trading capital should not be funds necessary for essential expenses such as paying bills, insurance, or education costs for your children, or even paying off for loans and mortgages and so on. Let's say if you lose money in trading, it should not disrupt your daily lifestyle. So you can see that when you are able to fulfill these conditions above, then when it comes to trading, you can trade with lesser external pressures, especially financial pressures from your daily lives. So that this allows you to make decisions based on strategy rather than emotionally driven decisions such as fear or desperation of needing money. So how much money you need in order to start up for trading? Well, the exact amount varies depending on individual circumstances and trading goals. Generally, the more trading capital that you have, the better it is. Because with more capital, you can diversify your strategies, you can manage risk more effectively, and potentially increase your returns. So it's important to remember that trading carries inherent risk. And even with careful preparation, losses in trading are possible. So you need to plan your finances well and make sure you trade with excess money that you can afford to lose. If you want to survive trading for the long run, you must set your trading rules. Now, setting trading rules is indeed crucial for maintaining discipline and consistency in your trading approach. You must be wondering, what are trading rules? Now, trading rules are like traffic rules in our daily lives. They provide clear guidance on what actions to take in specific situations. So it's similar like how traffic lights dictate our behavior on the road. So when you come to red, like what are you going to do? When the traffic light turns green, what are you going to do next? So these are what we call as the traffic rules. Similarly, in trading, we need to have trading rules. So trading rule serves as a clear guidance. Trading rule outlines specific actions for you to take based on predetermined criteria. So for instance, let's say if you are using trend lines, you might have a rule that dictates what to do when the trend line is broken during an uptrend. So you can see trading rules can be based on various technical indicators or chart patterns. Let me give you a few examples. If you're using trend lines, when the trend line is broken, you can consider exiting long positions or even entering short positions. Another example, when the price breaks above resistance line, you can consider, you know, entering long positions or tightening your stop loss level if you have a short position. You can use technical indicators like the simple moving averages. When prices crosses above simple moving average, you may consider buying opportunities. When price crosses down moving averages, you may consider selling opportunities. So you can see that, you know, trading rules don't need to be overly complicated. In fact, simpler rules are often easier for almost everyone to follow and execute consistently. However, they should still be comprehensive enough for you to cover various scenarios and provide a clear guidance for you during trading. For starters, trading rules should be fixed and predefined so that it leaves you no room for any ambiguity or emotional decision making. So when your trading rules are fixed and clearly defined, they can serve as a blueprint for your trading actions and help remove any subjectivity from your decision making process. While it's important to have fixed rules, as you accumulate trading experience and knowledge along the way, your trading strategies will continue to evolve and improve. So continuous improvement ensures that your rules remain effective and relevant over time. So by sticking to well-defined trading rules, traders can maintain discipline, manage risk more effectively, and increase the consistency of their trading performance over the long run. Do you have a risk management approach? Do you have a cut loss mechanism in your trading? And do you know how many positions you are going to trade? So these are part and parcel of a risk management approach. So yes, risk management is a fundamental aspect of successful trading, and it involves various strategies to protect your capital and minimize losses. So here are some key components of risk management that you can take into consideration. The first thing is risk assessment. Before entering any trade, it's essential for you to assess the potential risk involved. Now, this includes analyzing factors such as the market volatility, the potential for adverse price movements, and looking at the overall market conditions. So when you understand these risks, it allows you to make more informed decisions and adjust your position size accordingly. Having a clear trading rules, it's also part of a risk assessment process. Position sizing. Determining an appropriate position size for each trade is crucial for managing risk. Now, position sizing involves calculating the amount of capital to allocate to a particular trade based on factors such as your risk tolerance, your account size, the confidence level of each trading setup. It also takes into consideration of your personal trading strategies that you set for yourself. By properly sizing your positions, you can limit the impact of potential losses on your overall capital. Implementing stop loss order is one of many important risk management techniques that helps limit losses on every individual trades. Now, a stop loss order is placed at a predetermined level, and it will automatically trigger a market order to close that position if price move against you beyond a specified point. This ensures that losses are kept within acceptable limits and helps protect your capital from significant drawdowns. You may want to consider risk-reward ratio as well, because assessing the potential risk-reward ratio for each trade is essential for determining whether a trade is worth taking. So, a favorable risk-reward ratio involves setting a target profit level that is significantly higher than the potential losses if a trade is going against you. By focusing on trades within a favorable risk-reward ratios, you can improve the overall profitability of your trading strategy while keeping your risk under control. So you can see, by incorporating all of these risk management principles in your trading approach, you can better protect your capital, minimizing losses, and also improve the consistency of your trading performance over time. So in conclusion, by preparing sufficient trading capital, establishing clear trading rules, and developing effective risk management approach, you are well set to succeed in trading mid to long term. When you have all of these elements, you gradually develop a robust trading system that would allow you to minimize your trading risk, survive in the market longer, and achieving your trading goals. Of course, along the way, as you gained trading experience and improve your knowledge and skills, you continue to fine-tune and improve your trading system so that you are able to adapt to changing market conditions, improve your trading performance, and achieve long-term success. So that's it. These are the three key elements you must develop so that you can sustain your trading over the long run. When you have a comprehensive trading system, trading can be much easier, trading can be fun, and you can also get the positive results that you want from trading as well. If you find this video informative and useful to you, please share this video and give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed to our YouTube channel, please consider clicking on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so that you don't miss any future updates. Thanks for tuning in. Until next time, this is CY Soh. Good luck and good trading.